On the phone with us, one of the best pound-for-pound fighters on the planet, boxing champion Devin Haney. He works hard. He just got out of the gym. First of all, let's talk about this. Darren Check, and Zapata. Did you see that? That was crazy. 8 knockdowns.
Wow, I didn't even know that it was that many knockdowns, but that fight was crazy. I definitely think it was KO of the year, maybe fight of the year as well.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, speaking of what could be fight of the year, November 7th, Devin Haney, Yuriorkis Gamboa. He's a former gold medalist. He's a person that beat Salido. We all know Salido beat Lomachenko. And Devin, a lot of people are telling me, oh, it's easy for Devin. There's no easy fights. Talk to me about your fight November 7th.
You know, especially with an opponent like Gamboa, you cannot take him lightly. You know, he comes to fight every single time. You know, it has not been an easy fight for anyone yet. He's been in there with, you know, the best of them. So I have to definitely bring my A game and be prepared for any type of style that Gamboa will bring to the table, because he's a veteran and he has a lot of experience.
And he has nothing to lose.
Nothing to lose, everything to gain. So I know that he's coming to fight and he's going to put it all on the line.
Absolutely. Now, I've seen you work very hard. You're working with Mickey Bay right now. How's that working with Mickey Bay? And I think you're bringing in another coach as well, right?
No, between my dad and Mickey Bay, those are my two coaches. You know, my dad is my head coach, and Mickey Bay is the assistant coach. You know, and camp has been going great. I'm feeling good. I'm feeling ready. We're 5 weeks out, and I'm feeling like I'm ready to fight tomorrow.
Well, that's huge. Now, to me, the best division in boxing is 135, and there's so many great names and so many great fights. So I'm going to run some of these fights by you, and I want to see if you could put your analyst hat on and break them down for me. So let's start with this. Teofimo Lopez, he's also a 135 champ, against Lomachenko, who's also a 135 champ.
I think that's a great fight. I know that Teofimo Lopez is going in there, and you know, he feels like he's going to knock Lomachenko out. He's going in there to try to knock Loma out. So, and Loma, he's a much bigger guy. Loma's a much smaller guy, but Loma has the experience. I'm excited to see that fight. You know, hopefully, maybe I fight the winner. We'll see.
And hopefully, now tonight, Mark Kriegel, he's one of the broadcasters on ESPN. He said that he interviewed Lomachenko, and I don't know if you heard what Loma told him about you.
No, I didn't hear what
he said. He said that Loma really wants to fight Devin Haney because he said Devin Haney is not a real champion. Not a real WBC champion, sorry.
You know, I hope that he can, you know, show me and show the world how much of not a real champion I am, and we can make the fight happen, because I became champion because he decided not to fight me. They asked for an elevation. I didn't.
You welcome that fight. You would love it.
I would love that fight. And I've been saying this before. I've been calling Loma out, you know, for a few years now.
Definitely. So that's a big possibility. Now, another fight is 2 weeks after that. They're going to have actually fans at the Alamo Dome. Gervonta Tank Davis, who I was at the gym actually when you sparred him, against Leo Santa Cruz, a four-division champ, a fighter that's 37-1-1. Tank is 23-0, 22 knockouts. How do you see that fight unfolding?
I like Leo. I think that he's a great fighter. You know, he's a much smaller guy coming up in weight to challenge himself. So you have to give him the utmost respect for that. But I just think that, you know, Tank will be too much for him.
So you got Gervonta winning. Do you think decision, knockout?
Oh, I'm not sure on that part yet. On if it will be a knockout or not. But I definitely think that it's going to be a good fight. That Leo Santa Cruz is, you know, coming to fight. He's not going to lay down. He's going to put it all on the line.
Okay. Hold
like
on.
Like you say, the fans are the winners.
Absolutely. That's my slogan. The fans are the winners. And then what else I was going to tell you. So those are two fights in your division right there. There's another one that's coming up, and they don't have a date exactly yet, but obviously it's Ryan Garcia. You've known him for years. You fought him 6 times in the amateurs. He has a very tough fight. I think he's going to pull it off. But Luke Campbell's no joke. Former gold medalist, southpaw, fought Loma in a great fight.
I think a lot of people are underestimating Ryan. You know, I think that they forget how much experience and how good Ryan really is. I think Ryan will go in there and he'll make easy work of Campbell.
You think easy work, so quickly?
I wouldn't say quickly. I wouldn't say an early knockout. Maybe not, but I just think it would be fairly easy for him.
Now, when I talk to people about Devin Haney, and then I was just on Friday in one of the gyms in LA, and there was a coach named Jerry Rosenberg. He's been around boxing forever. He had 50 pro fights himself, and I asked him about you. And he told me Devin Haney is the closest thing. He is the next Floyd Mayweather. It's something that you've been hearing for many years, Devin. How do you take that compliment, or how do you take when people say that?
Jerry knows his stuff. Jerry has been in the game for a very long time. So he's a credible source. He's been around me. He saw me put in work. He saw me in the gym, and he saw me many times. So he knows what I'm capable of.
And obviously he knows Floyd Mayweather. But why do people compare you to Floyd? Is it because your defense is impeccable? Is it because your boxing IQ, your skills? What do you think it is?
Many different coaches will say different things of why they compare me. Some people say, defense. Some people say because of my work ethic, speed, many different things. Everyone has a certain perspective on it.
And Devin, obviously, you've known Floyd since you were very young. Floyd Mayweather actually introduced you to me. For one of the times I came to Vegas, he's like, Elie, come here. I want you to meet this young gentleman. He's going to be a future superstar. Now, what is it like to grow up around Floyd? And in recent months, we've seen you and Floyd work together, doing mitts and other stuff. And what is it do you take from those experiences being around an icon like Floyd?
I'm very grateful of the opportunity to have been around such a great fighter like Floyd, and especially me to be in deep into my career. I wouldn't say my prime, but deep into my career where I can take a lot of the things that he taught me and apply them right now. So I'm very grateful of that.
Does it seem like real, or to you it's normal because it's Floyd and you know him? But he's like the best fighter of our era. And for him to give you the time to even acknowledge and work with you is a big compliment.
Yeah, and a lot of people don't know is I've been around Floyd since I was 8, 9 years old. Floyd has always, been a mentor to me and helping me whenever, I needed something or, if he felt like I needed to work on something. So, I thank him for that.
By the way, speaking of when you were young, I saw a picture of you and Gamboa. I don't know if you were age or 7. I don't know what age you were. But you met the guy that you may knock out in the next few weeks. What was that like to meet someone that back then was like one of the biggest names in boxing?
It's crazy because, I used to go, I remember this one time I went to, my grandma let me stay at the gym longer at night just to watch Gamboa work out. I had to go home and do homework and stuff like that. And my grandma let me watch Gamboa work out. And, now I'm fighting him. So it's just crazy how the universe works and how the world works. And I can only thank God for, everything that, has come full circle. And, I'm very blessed to be in the position that I am today.
Now, you have Gamboa November 7th. Everybody should tune in on the zone. It's a big fight. It's a big night of boxing. You take care of business, which I believe you do, but again, you can't take anyone for granted because it's boxing and everybody's dangerous.
Yes.
Line up your next few fights. Who would Devin Haney want to fight after Gamboa? If you had a choice, anybody on the planet, any weight.
I would say right now, I would have to say, now that I had time to think of it, I would have to say, the Loma, because then it would be for the undisputed, it would be for all the belts in the 135-pound division.
For the real WBC championship.
Yes. Yes, and then I would have to say Tank. Then I would have to say Ryan Garcia. Then I would have to say I don't know, someone at 140. I don't know. I'm watching the fight. It seems like Josh Taylor and Ramirez are gonna go up in weight, so I don't know. But those are the three fights that I can look forward to, coming up.
Yeah, that would be great. And then, obviously, you and Gary Russell have exchanged words. I've always been really cool with Gary. He's always been nice to me. So, and you're really cool with me. So, what happens? What's the latest on that? Because I was telling people I want to see that fight.
Yeah, I feel like a lot of people did want to see the fight. But Gary Russell really didn't want to make the fight happen. He just was, a lot of bark and not enough bite. He talked the talk. But when it was time to, sign a contract and get to the real part, He didn't want to do that.
And that's one thing, Devin, I want to explain to people listening to this. You want to fight the best. You've always had, even when you were younger. I mean, you always want to fight the biggest names, but it takes two to tango. And in the end of the day, you have to fight who's in front of you.
Yeah, I never, if you can ask anyone, I never turned down any fights. Any fights that made sense, I always you know, approached him with head on and wanted to make them happen.
And speaking of fights that are coming up, there was talk of Manny Pacquiao, Conor McGregor. What do you feel about that? And what do you feel if anybody ever said, you know what, Eddie Hearn calls you and says, Conor would like to fight you, Devin?
I mean, I feel like it would be a good fight, you know, for boxing, you know, me and Conor. I don't think that's a realistic thing that would happen or anything like that. I like Conor because, you know, just the charisma that he has. You know, I respect him in the UFC, but when it comes to boxing, it's something totally different. And that goes on to, you know, him fighting Manny Pacquiao. It's a boxing game. It's totally different.
Yeah, it's true. What do you think Manny does with him? If they do end up mixing it up.
I think he makes easy work of him, you know, because, like I said, you know, the boxing game is much different than the MMA fighting and all that. You know, if Manny went to MMA, then Conor would, you know, kill him. If he came to boxing ring, it would be the same thing.
That's true. No, a shark can be a lion and a lion can't be a shark. Now, Devin, what a lot of people don't know about you, you do a lot in the community, you do a lot to help people. I want you to share some of those things that you do that people really don't know much about. Well, not only, because everyone knows you're the star, you're the champion, you're the boxer.
I like to give back a lot. And some people see it, some people don't. You know, when I do post it, they say, oh, well, why are you posting it? Why are you really doing it for that? But I do a lot of stuff that a lot of people don't see. Like, I actually, you know, go and spend time with the homeless and feed them and give them sleeping bags and tents and all type of things like that. And, you know, kids, I go and help the less fortunate kids as well, you know, because at the end of the day, they are the future, you know. So if you start now, you know, maybe you can lead them on the right path. But a lot of people, they don't know about it, and it's okay. Because it comes from the heart.
It does come from the heart, but at the same token, if they see you do it, it can encourage them to do it. If Devin Haney does it, you know what I mean?
Yes, so, and I say that, but, you know, the world is always going to say something. People are always going to talk good or bad. You know, at the end of the day, it is what it is.
Just like the fight with Gamboa. Some people criticize that. I'm like, listen, in the end of the day, it's boxing and we want to see fights. And that's the fight that's happening. And Gamboa has the resume. He has the name. He just had a great fight with Tank. So
Gamboa is no slouch.
You can't pay attention to everything that people say. So a couple more and I'm done. Danny Garcia against Errol Spence.
Danny Garcia versus Errol Spence. I like Danny. I like Errol. I think it's a good matchup. It's a good fight for boxing. But I gotta go with Errol.
Okay, and then Crawford Kell Brook.
Crawford.
Why?
Easy. I just think that he's just too versatile, and he's just too much for Kell Brook. Seems like every time Kell Brook stepped up, he lost. But I like Kell Brook. I met Kell Brook one time when I was in London. He was a great guy. He showed a lot of respect. You know, I wish him the best.
And right now, where do you think, like, your biggest fan base? Is it in the U.S.? Is it the U.K.? Is it worldwide?
Oh, it's by far the U.S. Even though the U.K. people support me, you know, I went there and I did a media workout, and it was crazy how many people were there. Like, the gym was packed. Like, you couldn't even get in the door. But, the U.S., you know, here they support me the most, but I also have crazy support in the U.K.
And then the Lakers are up 2-0 against Miami. Did they finish it this week?
I think Heat will win one game.
So you say 4-1. So, Devin Haney, your message to all your fans, people who love you and support you?
Thank you guys for all the support. Tune in November 7th. Put on a great performance. I can't wait to, you know, get back in the ring. It's been almost a year since I've been off. Can't wait to showcase, you know, all my skills and, you know, one step closer to being where I want to be.
And what message do you have for Yuriorkis Gamboa if he's listening to this?
Train hard, stay healthy. You know, we so we can put on a great fight for the fans on November 7th.
And the last
people
thing,
watching on TV.
Make sure to tune in on November 7th. What do you tell Lomachenko on the eve of his fight?
Good luck. You know, hopefully you fight me after, so you show me that how much I'm not a real champion. If that's what you believe, show me.
There you have it, Devin Haney, the one and only 135 world champion. Tune in November 7th, him and Gamboa, must see TV. It's on the zone. You can't miss it. FaceNewsReporting.com and Mesa Back Reporting.